ever talk about, and it's a topic we personally hate as individuals, okay? And that's probably why we don't talk about it. The song is all about the concept of waiting, and specifically waiting on God's timing in your life and for God to act within His timing, not your own. And there's nothing more in this life than we hate than waiting on things. Is that not true? We hate the wait. We want instant results. We want instant answers. We want instant solutions. We want instant information, instant gratification, instant pleasure, instant fulfillment, instant relief. And I can make the list go on and on and on. Everything in our lives, we want to happen just like that. And we hate to wait. But that's what this song is going to talk about today, is how we have to wait. And what you see in Scripture is this. Waiting is one of the main components of developing a healthy spiritual life. You will see it throughout the Scriptures. Waiting is one of the greatest ways that God teaches us spiritual health and how to rely on Him and actually see His hand at work in our lives. So with that said, we're going to watch a video, then I'll come back up and talk about the song.
Watching the time slipping, I'm on a decline. I don't think this is where I belong.
Yeah.
And I've been trying to climb, keeping the end on my mind, but it feels like it's way too long. I know I need to relax, cause it's all fine. You say you got my back in the hard times.
Yeah.
But sometimes I forget, I need to remind myself it's all in your hands. Even if I'm in the fire, living through the storm. I know that you're fighting and never leave me alone.
Nah.
Even when I get tired of looking for answers that can't be found, I guess I gotta wait right now.
Even when I see the water is rising.
Just not to give up, feels like I'm singing the same old song. Got blows, I'm trying to duck, keep getting punched in the gut. How much longer can this go on? I know I need to relax, cause it's all fine. Just keep me in the light through the dark times. Especially when I forget, would you please remind me that it's all in your hands. Even if I'm in the fire, living through the storm. I know that you're fighting and never leave me alone.
Yeah.
Even when I get tired of calling out and don't ever hear a sound. I guess I gotta wait right now.
Even when I see the waters rising.
Trusting you, you know just what I'm needing, and you got a reason, so it's okay, I just wait right now. Even when I'm uncomfortable, I know nothing's too tough for you, so I can't believe that you're still keeping me safe right now, even though I gotta wait right now.
Is gotta wait, and I didn't think it would actually make the radio, but someone this morning when they heard it playing when they first came in, I think it was Annie, was like, I've already heard that on the radio. I was like, I didn't think he'd hear that one on the radio because it's a little bit lower quality and he's a new artist. But anyways, it's a great song with a great message, and so that's what we're going to look at now, is we're just going to kind of walk through the narrative of that song and this concept of waiting. So here's the lyrics. It says this: now I've been watching the time slipping on the decline, I don't think this is where I belong. So the way the song starts off is this guy is clearly dealing with some issue in his life, and he's trying to wait on God's timing, but it's getting harder and harder to wait for God to intercede. So he's starting to struggle with that. And he says, and I've been trying to climb, keeping the end in my on my mind, but it feels like it's way too long. So the next thing you see that happens in his life, and we've all experienced this, is as he's waiting for God, the temptation starts to set in that he needs to take control over the situation. He needs to just take it back from God because it seems like God's taking too long and God's just not answering him. So he's like, I got to take this thing back into my hands. And that's the temptation he's starting to face. The next part of the song says this, I know I need to relax because it's all fine. You say you got my back in the hard times, but sometimes I forget I need to remind myself it's all in your hands. And so what he realizes at this point of the song is, I have an issue. I'm waiting for God. God doesn't seem to be answering in the time frame I want him to. So at this point, what he starts to realize is this is not a healthy mental space for him to live in, where he feels like he is in control of everything. Because what he learns is this, he forgot the sovereignty of God. And if you don't know what the sovereignty of God means, it just means this, that God is overall. Okay, that God is the ultimate authority. He is sovereign over everything. He has authority over everything. And he had forgotten that somewhere in his life. And what happens when you forget that God is sovereign, that God is over everything, what you do is you add even more pressure and more stress to your life during challenging times that already have enough stress and pressure with them just on their own. And you add like another whole layer on it when you start thinking you are the one in control of everything and it's all about you and you hold all the power in your hands. And what he comes to the realization here is this, he needs to just relax, okay? He needs to dial it back some, he needs to relax, and he needs to understand the way I do that, the way I relax is I have to start trusting God. Even though his timing's not my timing, I have to learn to start trusting God. That's what you see start happen here. Next part of the song says this, even if I'm in the fire or living through a storm, I know that you're fighting and never leave me alone, okay? So here he reminds himself that even through the challenges of his life, he is not on his own, even though he might perceive it that way. And this guy isn't odd. As I'm going through the song, I'm like, I've been in all these same places this guy has, which is those times you're waiting on God and you feel alone and you start to perceive that God's not there, that you're just on your own. And that's where he's feeling it at this point. But then he remembers, God is always with me, okay? And we see this in Matthew 28:20. This is a promise from Jesus. He says, I am with you always, even to the end of the age, that I'm always there with you. Even if you perceive that I'm not, I am, okay? And here's the problem with this one. I think this is why we get into this mindset. We never know what God protects us from because we never have to go through it. And so the only times we're looking for God usually to interact in our life is when challenges come and when stressful times come. Then we start looking for God's direct hand on things to see if we can see where it's at. And then if we see where it's at, we feel like God's with us. And if we don't see where it's at, we feel like God's not there. Yet we forget all the times we're not in a challenge and we go, maybe God was protecting us in those times and God was still there in those times. It's just, I wasn't thinking about it. The fact that you're still alive sitting here right now, who's to say God hasn't protected you from dying five different times? You just didn't have to see it, so you don't know it. And so you could perceive that as God wasn't there when actually he was and he saved you multiple times in your life, okay? That's what he starts talking about here. Now, the next thing is this. This next line in the song, there's two different ways it's said because this verse gets sung twice and it changes the lyrics. So that's where you see one and two. First time it's sung and then the second time it's sung. It says this, even when I get tired, and the first line says, of looking for answers that can't be found. How many have been there before? Where you're looking for answers that you know you're probably not going to find what those answers are on this side of heaven. Okay? So you're looking for answers that can't be found. And the second time there it says, and calling out and not hearing a sound. Ever been there where you're begging God to give you an answer, begging God to explain things to you, and it was a silence, and you got nothing, and you were sitting there like, where is God? Okay, that's what he's expressing here. He says, in those moments, I guess I gotta wait right now. In those moments, I'm not gonna get mad at God. In those moments, I'm not gonna assume God's not here, In those moments, he's going, I guess I just got to wait. I just have to sit and be patient, and I'm going to have to wait. And that is the main theme of this song, which is we have to learn how to wait in healthy ways in our spiritual life, how to wait in a healthy way for God's timing and for God to do what God wants to do in his own time. I want you to understand this, and I want you to accept this, that God is not obligated to respond to your desires and your wishes in your desired ways and your times. Okay? This is a hard one for us to accept. This is a hard one for us to understand because we hate this. But God is not obligated to respond to your desires and your wishes in your desired ways and desired times, because you are you and he is God. Sovereign, you are not, and he's not obligated to what you want. Okay? So in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 8, the Apostle Paul, the guy who writes two-thirds of the New Testament text, he learned this lesson. So he goes to God at one point, and he is having some type of physical struggle. We don't know what it is, but he refers to it as a thorn in his side. So it's something that's really bothering him, and it's affecting his daily life and his quality of life. Whatever it is, he has a real struggle. And he says this in verse 8. He says, three different times I begged the Lord to take it away. So the guy who writes two-thirds of the New Testament text, incredible man of God, starts the entire beginning of the Gentile church, all that. He prays to God to take it away three different times. And his response he gets back that he felt God was saying to him was this: my grace is all you need. My power works best in your weakness. So basically, Paul, sorry, just wait on it, okay? I work best in your weaknesses. My grace is enough for you. You're just going to have to deal with it right now. And you might not understand why. I'm not going to explain it to you why. It's just you're going to have to learn to wait. And then Paul goes on later to that where he talks about, and that's why I now talk about my weaknesses, because when I am weak, I am strong. And he learns that is where God started to develop him into a stronger faith and a more mature faith than he had before. The next part of the song says this: even when I see the waters rising, you're the light when the sun ain't shining. When there's no silver lining, it's all in your timing, so I guess I gotta wait right now. Now, I'm gonna give you three different parts of healthy ways to wait on God, and he's gonna lay them out in the song. The first one you see here, which is this: you have to learn to know that God knows better than you do, even if you can't see how current circumstances have any value to you. Okay, this is a tough lesson, but it's a lesson we have to learn, which is you have to learn God's smarter than you. God has a better idea of what's going to be best for you and best for this world and best for his kingdom. Even if in the midst of the circumstances you're in, you can't see any value to it and you go, there's nothing good that can come from this, you have to learn to wait on God and go, but God obviously can see how something good can come from this. And you have to learn how to wait without answers. In Isaiah 55:8, it says this: my thoughts are nothing like your thoughts, says the Lord, and my ways are far beyond anything you could imagine. You could say imagine, you could say understand, that God's ways are beyond anything we can comprehend. Therefore, when we feel like he's not there, therefore, when we feel like we're not getting the answers we want, we wait, because God knows more than I do, okay? And that's the proper thing we should do, is wait on his timing, wait for his response. Says this: when it's hard to believe it, I know you'll make a way somehow, but I guess I gotta wait right now. So now he brings up another part of learning how to wait in a healthy way, and that is to refuse to take matters into your own hands that you've already put into God's hands. What I mean by that is this: oftentimes when challenges come up in our life, the first place we turn is where, typically, as Christians? Okay, we turn to prayer, we turn to God, right? And we throw it in his hands and go, God, it's in your hands. I need you to address this. I trust you to do something with this. Now, next thing that happens is when he doesn't immediately respond or we get the answers we want, the temptation that comes in is, I put it in God's hands, but I need a solution now. So I'm going to take it back from God and I'm going to figure out the solution. And I'm just going to force it to happen. And the second part of learning to wait in a healthy way is you have to learn you can't do that. When you put something in God's hands, you leave it in his hands until he responds, until you find a clear answer. Let me just say this real quick. I want to speak in code. If you're newer here, newer to your faith, and you go, well, how does that happen? Like, does God verbally talk to you? things like that. I've never heard God's voice ever. He's never verbally talked to me ever, okay? So this is a side note. This has nothing to do with my notes, but I thought I need to address this real quick. What do I mean by God answering or God tells you whatever? Certain things happen in your life that you can't deny or other than God interceding and doing that. At times, it can be you're reading your scriptures and a scripture pops out to you that seems to speak directly to the situation you're in, and you go, that gave me a direct answer of what I'm supposed to do now as I came across a scripture. Here's a weird one with that one. I've had God show me things like that before. And then I go read it like 3 years later and go, how did that mean anything to me? Has anyone else had that happen? But in the moment, somehow God spoke through that scripture that gave me a very clear understanding of what I was supposed to do and what God wanted, okay? The other ways it happens is you will find maybe several people saying the same general thing to you in a very short period of time, and you're like, that wasn't coincidence because I'm just praying about that. It's an issue I'm going through. God's speaking through people to me to help me understand this is what I want to do, okay? So most of the time when I say God's speaking or God revealing things, it's being aware and attentive when I'm praying and looking for answers and then seeing them when God puts them before you. And he works through people, he works through scriptures, he works through scenarios and situations at times where you go, oh, there's no way that'll happen unless God was pointing me here or here. So when I say God speaking to you again answers, that's how I have seen it. Maybe God speaks to some people. I don't know. He just never has to me directly where I hear a voice. That's how I've always seen it, where I can see his hand on things. But that does not mean I pray for it and the next day I get the answers. There have been things I've waited 6 months, a year, 2 years. One of them I waited 8 years, okay, to hear God and give me direction of what I should do, and I just had to wait. The eight-year one was excruciating, okay, of waiting 8 years to hear what God's wanted me to do or what I was supposed to do. And those are hard times. But that's what I mean by God speaking. Now, going back to James chapter 1, verses 5 and 6. So second lesson here is when you put things into God's hands, you don't take it back. That's one of the things of learning to wait. James says it like this. He says, if you need wisdom, ask our generous God, and he will give it to you. So ask God what you need. He will not rebuke you for asking. So he's not going to be like, how do you not know what to do? He's not going to rebuke you that way. He's going, great, you asked me. He says, but when you ask, be sure your faith is in God alone. Not yourself, not others. Make sure your faith is in God alone, that you're asking him for the answer, and you're going to look to him for the answer nowhere else. So that's that lesson. Next part of song brings up the third part of learning how to wait in a healthy way. It says, stuck in a rut, fighting just not to give up, feels like I'm singing the same old song. So it's just like my life is replaying the same way and nothing's ever changed. It doesn't seem anything's changed. I'm just stuck in a loop. And the part here that we learn from the song is this. Another part of healthy waiting is learning the discipline to just keep doing what you know is right, even when you seem to have no tangible results of that. So you just keep doing what you know is right, even though it doesn't seem like there's any good results or tangible results. You still just keep doing what you know you're supposed to be doing. I learned this one, I think from Autumn, I used to say this, so as Autumn will say from time to time, hopefully I get this right, that you just do the right thing even if you don't feel like it at times. You just keep doing the right thing, right? So you keep plugging away at it. And one of the temptations we get when we're waiting is to start doing things we know aren't fully correct, to start kind of stepping around the corner some and crossing the lines here and there just to get the answers we want to get. And one of the things we have to learn is when you feel like you're in that rut and you're doing a routine, the discipline of learning to continue to do the routine of doing the right thing over and over, it will pay off, okay? It will work in your favor. Galatians 6:9, it says this, so let's not get tired of doing what is good, okay? Don't get tired of doing what is good. At just the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessing if we don't give up. And I love the way this is phrased in this translation, it's at just at the right time. So in God's time, which is the right time, God will intercede, God will take care of things, God will work, okay? But in the meantime, you have to wait. You just keep doing good. You keep doing what you know you're supposed to do. Next part of the song says this, got blows, I'm trying to duck, keep getting punched in the gut, how much longer can this go on? And so now you're just getting a sense of this guy where he's going, this time of waiting is just becoming overwhelming to the point that he feels like he's going to break. Like, I just don't feel like I could take one more punch. I feel like I'm on the verge of collapse. That's where he's at. And he says this. He says, I know I need to relax because it's all fine. Just keep me in the light through the dark times, especially when I forget. Would you please remind me that it's all in your hands? So when he's going, I'm about ready to snap. I feel like everything's going to collapse. I can't do this anymore. He's going, I just got to relax. I got to chill out, because the key to healthy waiting is this. It's learning to rest and trust in the sovereignty of God. That even though I don't know what the heck's going on, even though I don't know why in the world these things are continuing to happen, why I keep getting punched, why this stuff keeps falling apart, even though I don't know any of those answers, the one thing I do know is that God is sovereign. God is overall. And the only thing I can do is trust in that. And if I would trust in that, then I learn how to relax here. I learn how to take some of that stress off of me, because I remember he knows what he's doing, even if I have no clue. Okay? And he takes refuge in that. Now, next part of the song, and this is a quicker part, so I try to keep this message a little quicker here, because we got kids today, so I don't bore you too much. Okay? Next part of the song, he goes through kind of his new healthy mindset. So he's kind of addressed, here's some things you have to learn how to wait in a healthy way. The next part of the song, I think you kind of see this guy going, here's what I've learned now. Here's some of the things I have learned that have helped me, that now this is part of my mindset. And it seems to be built on this foundation that I want to give you, which is from Romans 12:12. Okay? Romans 12:12 very simply says this: be patient in trouble. So wait in God's timing in trouble, and keep praying. So when you're in trouble, when you're having to wait, you be patient and you keep praying. You don't stop praying, you keep praying. Even if it doesn't seem like you're getting answers, you keep praying in those times while you're waiting. If you do this, then you'll learn the same lessons this guy has about his mindset. So he says this. He says, I know there's no need rushing you. When I don't see you, I trust in you. So his new mindset, one of the things he has learned is to wait even when he's feeling blind. So when he's not able to see anything, he's not able to see where this ends, how there's a solution, when he can't see any of that, when he's blind to what the future holds, he's learned just to wait. Okay, I'm not gonna operate on my own. I'm not gonna jump the gun. I'm not gonna take things into my own hands and try to force things. I'm just gonna sit and I'm gonna learn to wait, and I'm gonna pray to God, and I'm gonna trust his timing, and he's learned to wait now. The next line he says, you know just what I'm needing, and you've got a reason. So next thing he has now learned in his life is that in these times of waiting, he trusts that God has a reason, and that he trusts God's wisdom. And this is, like I said, this is always hard to get to. The point in your life where you go, I don't understand things, I don't like how things are going, I can't see anything beneficial happening, but I trust God has a reason. And it's hard to say that when things are painful in your life. To say, I trust God's got a reason. And here's what I need you to understand, and he's embraced this. There are some hard things God lets you go through because you need to go through them. Okay? If you don't go through some hard times, you never grow. Some of the greatest wisdom you'll ever learn, some of the greatest faith journeys you'll ever go on, are through some of the hardest struggles you'll have in your life. And through those hard struggles, you come out a new person with a deeper faith and a deeper reliance on God, and a more effective person for the kingdom of God. And sometimes, as much as we hate to say this, God's willing to go, I'm going to let you go through it. Okay? That does not mean God's always causing the stuff. It just means God's not coming in and intervening to stop it. Because he knows if I let them go through this, they're going to grow through it if they handle it properly. Our role is to handle it properly, the wait, to trust God, to understand his wisdom is greater than ours. And that's what this guy seems to have learned in his lyrics in the song. The last thing he says is this: so it's okay. It's okay. This is a hard one to say. God, when I have to wait, it's okay. Because what you're saying by it's okay is you're accepting that he's in control and you're not. And so he says, so it's okay. I'll just wait right now. Even when I'm uncomfortable, I know nothing is too tough for you. So it's okay. I just have to wait right now. He finally has learned that waiting is okay, and that waiting is actually healthy for us at times, and that waiting on God is always the best option for us to go in our life. As much as we hate it, I would say there's nothing more we hate in life than waiting. But what we see in this song, what we see in the scriptures, is one of the best options in your life, one of the most greatest benefits you can have in your life is having to wait and not get instant answers and gratification. And just going, I have to sit. And it makes you learn this, I'm not as big, I'm not as important as I once thought I was. That I am just a messenger of God, I'm just one of his servants, I'm one of his children, but I am not God. I don't control the world, I don't control all the situations in the world, I'm not even responsible for everything. I'm responsible for me, and right now in this situation in my life, I just need to wait, and that's okay. The song just ends with this, so I can believe that you're still keeping me safe right now, even though I've got to wait right now. So he ends it with this, even though you don't see me, I've learned you're there. Even though I don't know you're working, I know you are. And so I just have to learn to wait. All right? Would you pray with me? Heavenly Father,